Hello everyone, welcome back to Punita's Science World. Students, in today's video, we are going to talk about more of nutrition in class. Students, as you all know that every organism needs some kind of energy and nutrients to ensure that the life process go on smoothly. Plants are also living things and they also need some form of energy. They have cells, they have tissues, they also grow in size. So in order to synthesize their food, they do have nutrient requirement. And that is why they show a kind of mode of nutrition by which they synthesize their own food, just by using simple inorganic substances to produce organic substances. But the method of obtaining food is different in different organisms, and hence we divide the mode of nutrition in two types. So if we talk about the types of nutrition, we divide it into two types. The first is autotrophic mode of nutrition and second is heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So in today's video, we are just going to talk about this mode, means the first one, that is the autotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, so let's move to the autotrophic mode of nutrition. Student, in autotrophic mode of nutrition, plants prepare their own food. So not only plants, the organisms which we count here in autotrophs are some plants, some algae and also some bacteria which we call cyanobacteria. In autotrophic mode of nutrition, organisms use simple inorganic matters like water and carbon dioxide. As you see in the description, they use water, they use carbon dioxide in presence of light and chlorophyll, and they synthesize their food on their own. Or in simple words, we can say that the process of photosynthesis is used to convert light energy. That means the process of photosynthesis converts light energy into food such as glucose. And the organisms which follow such nutrition, we call them autotrophs. And in this category, we count some plants, algae and bacteria. Most of the plants come in this category, but there are some exceptions too. So there are some plants, algae and bacteria which follow these kind of nutrition, which we call autotrophic nutrition. So now let's move to the description of this autotrophic nutrition. If I summarize the whole process of photosynthesis, you can summarize it as 6CO2 plus 6H2O gives glucose, that is 6H12O6 and 6 molecule of oxygen in the presence of sunlight. Okay. Now let's talk about the process. So here you can see the chlorophyll, that is the most important, you can say, the component of the photosynthesis. So students, plants have chlorophyll in them. Chlorophyll is a green color pigment which impart green color to the plants. Using carbon dioxide, sunlight and chlorophyll and also some inorganic substances, plant produce simple carbohydrate. This carbohydrate is further utilized by the plant to give them energy. And when there is an excess of carbohydrate, they store it for later use. Clear? So now let's talk about the process of the photosynthesis. Students, plants have these small openings on the surface of leaf. On this part, you will be able to find some small pores. These pores are called stomata. These are the small openings and guard cells surround the stomata. These stomata are the opening through which carbon dioxide enters the plant, or you can say the gaseous exchange takes place through these stomata. So the stomata are basically surrounded by guard cells, and through these pores, gaseous exchange, that means the CO2 and oxygen, means carbon dioxide and oxygen in plants, takes place. And also water is lost through these pores. The water lost through these pores has a special mechanism, and that mechanism is termed as transpiration. So basically, transpiration is the process of water movement. So remember that this is the process of water movement through a plant, and its evaporation, you can say, from aerial parts such as leaves, stems and flowers. So this basically, transpiration is water loss, is a process of water loss from the aerial parts such as leaves, stems and flowers. Students, water is necessary for plants, but only a very small amount of water is taken up by the roots for the growth and metabolism, and the rest of water is evaporated from aerial parts such as leaves, stems and flowers. Okay, now we are going to talk about the types of autotrophic nutrition. So basically, there are two type of autotrophic nutrition. The first is, as you can see here, the first one is photoautotrophic nutrition. This is called photoautotrophic because here sunlight is the energy source, whereas the second one is chemoautotrophic nutrition, and this termed as chemo because here chemicals are the energy source. Certain bacteria synthesize food, or you can say sugar, not by using sunlight energy but by extracting energy from chemical compound, and that is why they are referred to as chemoautotrophs. Clear? So we divide the autotrophic nutrition into two types. The first one is photoautotrophic, where sunlight is the energy source, and the second is chemoautotrophic nutrition, where the chemicals are the energy source. Now let's talk about the process of photosynthesis. So if we summarize the whole process of photosynthesis, this can be explained in three stages. The first is absorption, where chlorophyll present in the leaves trap the sunlight coming from the sun. Okay, so here absorption takes place. The second process is conversion, where the absorbed sunlight, or you can say the absorbed light energy, converted into chemical energy, and the water absorbed gets split into hydrogen and oxygen molecules. And the third stage is reduction, where carbon dioxide gets reduced, that is hydrogen molecules combine with carbon and they form carbohydrates, or you can say sugar molecules. I hope this is all clear to you. Now let's talk about the photosynthesis in desert-like habitat. As you all know that in desert-like habitat or in desert-like areas, there is a dearth of water. So, to avoid water loss, guard cells keep stomatal pores closed during the daytime. Desert plants take in carbon dioxide in the night and absorb it from the atmosphere, since their stomata remain closed during daytime. And in daytime, they make use of the absorbed carbon dioxide for the process of photosynthesis. That simply means during the daytime, they will use this stored carbon dioxide to perform photosynthesis. As well as the plant also depend on soil for micro and macro elements. And these elements are used to synthesize protein and other essential compounds required for the proper functioning and growth of the plant. I hope this is all clear to you. And this is all about the process of nutrition in plants. In the next video, we will discuss more about the mode of nutrition in animals. I hope this is all clear to you. Thank you, students.